Welcome to Teem Sports Entertainment, your one-stop shop for mature dialogue. We're going to get right to it. Welcome to Teem Sports Entertainment, the podcast, your one-stop shop for mature sports dialogue. I am your host, Earl Teemer, alongside my big uncle, my co-host, Alan Teemer. Before we go any further, please like the video, comment below, subscribe to the channel, and most importantly, hit the notification bell. That way you know Dream Team is when we upload new content. All right, we're getting right to it. Mm-hmm. The Phoenix Suns.
Yeah.
The Phoenix Suns. Mm-hmm. Currently 17-9 in the Western Conference. What, the fourth seed?
Right.
Fifth seed.
Yes, they are.
Fourth seed. Yeah.
Dream Team is, they're balling. Mm-hmm. They are balling.
How many they won in a row?
It's about six in a row. Yeah. Balanced attack.
Just knocked off Philly, and that was a tough game.
Yeah.
Booker is not the same Booker.
Yeah. Much more efficient. Yeah.
He went and got gangsta on. Yeah. I mean, he's more physical. He's up in your face.
He's not just a scorer. And if you look at their stats, he's averaging about 24. So it's not a bunch of, like you said, much more efficient. He's getting his buckets with less shots, but the ball is being moved around a lot more. Well, that's to be expected with Chris Paul there, right? You got Mikal Bridges averaging like 14.
I think Chris Paul is the best point guard in the league. And the reason why I say point guard, because point guards is not supposed to be scoring 35 and 40 and all that. And,
so would you go as far as to say he's the best leader in the league?
To me, he's one of the best leaders in the league. Yeah. Yes. He's in the definitely top five.
Yeah, because as we stated in the Western Conference preview, like, he's a culture changer. I don't care who's on the roster. Somehow, wherever he goes, things turn around.
His attitude, early on, people would say it's hard to get along. That's because you ain't a baller. You gonna play with him, you're gonna come to play. That's, and Hunter is on. Ayton.
Oh, Ayton. Yeah.
He's gonna benefit from. As long as he's humble and listening to what he's telling him, he's going to be fine. Yeah. They're going to be fine.
Yeah. Another unsung hero, man. Dream Teamers. Let's give props to Monty Williams, man.
Yeah.
He's coaching the hell out of that team.
Well, he always was a great coach to me. And it's not his first stance with CP3, Chris Paul. He coached him before when in New Orleans.
Oh, yeah, the David West years. Tyson Chandler and all of them.
And he was our young up-and-coming coach then, and his wife got sick. Remember that?
Yeah.
So, I mean, Phoenix.
Which had the tragic accident.
Yeah. They're not the Chris Paul trade. People start talking about him. But as the season goes, you can see that they was going to – not struggle, but they wasn't going to jump out the gate. I didn't think they was. But you're starting to see Chris Paul putting his stamp on that team.
Yeah. They look good, man. They got some ballers over there. You got Jay Crowder's over there. They have toughness and they have scoring. Chris Paul, like you say, is a great leader. He brings toughness.
Right.
He's a closer.
Mm-hmm.
He's a glue guy. Devin Booker is playing much better than he's ever played. Now, I get granted, most people would say, well, this is an individual who scored about 70 points in one game. He can put the ball in the hole, but now he's doing so much more, even defensively.
Right. He was doing that 70 points and all that kind of stuff on losing team. Team that's nowhere near ever going to be in the playoff, and people was basically crying for him.
Saying to get him off of
Phoenix.
Oh, yes, you're right.
But another one over there that's real, I mean, see, I'm not always looking at, when I say a lot of people out there who really not an NBA fan, they don't really understand. They just like the highlights. Mm. When you met some of the players I'll mention, they're not stars. They're not superstars. But Cameron Payne, he's been in the league for a while. But if you watch what he's doing over there, he's coming off the bench. He's solid. He's Monty Williams, and he can't do nothing but learn. Learning from CP3 and Monty Williams, he's doing a great job. Phoenix Suns.
They for real. Yep. Anytime Chris Paul is in the equation, they're for real. Listen, I hate to toot our own horn, but we mentioned that in the Western Conference preview.
Right.
We talked about CP3, how wherever he goes, you can look at the roster, maybe three players in the league that you can say that or have that argument for. Wherever they go, things change around.
Right.
And he's one of them. Mm-hmm. and they're balling right now. 17-9, the fourth seed in the Western Conference.
Mikal Bridges,
14 points a game, man. Yeah. You can go straight down the roster. They got some ballers over there, man.
I mean, we can talk about Etwan Moore, knockdown shooter. You already mentioned Crowder. That's more toughness, wing defending and all that. They got centers. Mm-hmm. Ayton and
Saric is over there. Right?
Saric is over there. I watched Saric play some great defense in the fourth quarter up against Embiid. I guess he was, you know, practiced with him, so he kind of knew his moves. But when you got a backup center and a center and all those wing players that's all around there, they're looking good. They're looking real good. And like again, this is early, and they're fifth. And this is basically that's a young team that had never experienced this.
Yeah.
They was always not nowhere near in the playoffs. But now and they're gonna learn and grow up until when the playoffs come. So all these other teams that thinking that, oh, we can walk in here and beat up on all these teams, they can't.
I don't think they believe that anymore. Not in Phoenix. No. They started off hot.
Yeah.
And they're sustaining it.
Right.
You know what I mean? So that's looking up over there in Phoenix, man. Because listen, man, the lights were shut off over there for quite some time.
For a while.
So as a fan of the game, man, you like to see teams that weren't doing well. You want to see competitive ball. Like if you cop in the league pass, you want to be like, all right, no matter what game I click on, I can enjoy the night.
Yeah.
And they're one of those teams.
Phoenix is one of those teams you can click it on.
Yeah. No doubt. So that's all I got to say. Anything else you got to say?
Phoenix Suns, better watch out.
Got it, man. Team Sports Entertainment, the podcast. Once again, this is Team Sports Entertainment, the podcast. I'm your host, Earl Teemer, alongside my co-host, a big unc, Alan Teemer. Like the video, leave a comment below, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell. We're here for the long haul. We appreciate all y'all out there. Dream Teemers, y'all be good.
Peace.